Hi viewers, for many years I use Volvo's oil filters and other brands on my Volvo S40 2.4 liter. In this video I will cut open 4 different oil filters and I will observe the amount of contaminants that each oil filter can capture.
My car is over 248,000 kilometers or 155,000 miles and it took me over a year to collect these 4 used oil filters. The intervals between the oil changes were always around 7,000 kilometers or 4,350 miles. On every occasion, I used the same kind of oil. It was the regular Castrol GTX 5W30. The procedure to collect the oil filters was always the same during every oil changes. I removed the oil filters and I stored them in plastic containers. They stayed in the containers until it was time to compare them. The basic function of oil filters is to keep the engine oil as clean as possible by catching high levels of contaminants. I spent some time reading about it, but each company uses its own marketing strategy to promote their filters. I needed more than marketing technical specs. I wanted to see with my eyes the dirt accumulated between the media pleats. So I decided to test it myself. My goal was to compare the quantity of contaminants that the cartridge filters were able to capture during my service intervals. I began my evaluation by gathering my 4 used filters. To cut the filters, I used the same kind of blade to see if some media were stronger than others. When I was cutting them, I did not feel any big difference. Anyways, I needed to get a sample stripe of filter media from each one of them to compare and measure them. As you can see, the filtering caps have different shapes. Therefore, the cap openings are not sealed the same way when the cartridge is installed in the filter housing. To simplify the evaluation, I place the filters in alphabetic order from left to right. The number 1 is a Fram and it is made in China. The number 2 is another Fram, but it was made in Germany. The number 3 is a Valvoline and it is made in China. The number 4 is also a filter made in China and it is the Wix. After, it was time to grab the filters and look between the pleats. With the Fram CH9954 number 1, I did not see that much dirt accumulation. Because the media had the smallest surface, I was expecting a better concentration of contaminants trapped in the pleats. With the Fram CH9954 number 2 from Germany, it was easy to see the black deposits inside the pleats. I was satisfied with the quality of filtration, but the problem with my German made is that it seems to have been replaced by the Chinese model in the stores around. The number 3 was the Valvoline V085 and this time I was surprised by the stiffness of the media pleats. It was difficult to unfold them, but the result was very good. I was pleased to see some nice black spots of contaminants. The last one was the Wix 57186. The filter was made with lots of pleats and they were very tight. I did not see any obvious spots of contaminants, but I liked the fact that there was a lot of pleats and surface to catch the dirt. To compare the surface between the 4 filters, I took the time to lay down the 4 media bands that I made. The easy way to display them was to stretch them and staple them side by side on the table. I simply measured them with a measuring tape. The number 1 was 25.5 inches long. The number 2 was better with 31 inches long. The number 3 was okay with 29 inches long. And the number 4 was the longest with 33.5 inches long. Now with the evolution of technology, there are more ways to build the media with combinations of cellulose, glass and synthetic fibers. So, depending on the mesh structure and the type of fibers, a small surface can be more efficient than a larger one. Another feature to observe is the design of the end cap. On the number 1, the plastic used to make the end caps was well made. I also noticed a loose fiber on the edge of the synthetic ring felt when I removed the filter. I wonder if the felt design has an effect on the volume of oil filtered by the media. The end caps of the Fram number 2 were not made with plastic. It looked like they were made with reinforced resin that was fused with the filter media. It was well engineered, but I found them easy to break after the media was cut. The Valvoline number 3 had plastic end caps and the media was strongly fastened to them. The inner contact edge of each end cap opening was well designed so it could fit tight and seal properly when it was installed in the housing. The last one was the wicks. The two plastic end caps were made with an opening that was designed to hold a small O-ring. These O-rings are used as sealers and they also help to maintain the cartridge in place when it is installed in the filter housing. Based on the overall result, combined with the type of oil that I use, I decided to select the Valvoline oil filter as a good alternative option to the original Volvo filters.
For a long time, I wanted to compare my oil filters. Now, I am glad to see that another popular brand can offer a good substitute. A better quality of oil can prolong the life of an engine, but it relies a lot on the efficiency of the oil filter.